Hello, I'm Unbrick Me, and today I'm going to be showing you how the very complex and sophisticated 8-speed sequential transmission gearbox works in the Lamborghini Sian FKP 37-42115. So as you can see, here's my chassis of the LEGO Technic Lamborghini, and I'm basically halfway done through the second stage of the building. And as you can see, I've taken off the fake V12 engine just to show you the gearbox more up close. But first of all, there are three settings here. This is the neutral, so basically you can spin this, which is, you know, connected to the fake engine. You can spin it and nothing is going to happen. But then, as soon as I put it into reverse, initially there is a 1-to-1 gear ratio, and this whole axle down the middle is connected to both the front differential and the back differential directly. So it's not connected to the gearbox, it just goes directly right through. So when you put it into reverse, it's just in one speed, completely unaltered by the gearbox. That is very cool in my opinion, since it's quite authentic in real cars. And then when we put it into the drive gear, as you can see, it immediately engages into the input of the gearbox itself. As you can see, it's very interesting since it's kind of like 2-speed transmission gearboxes, but in one. Basically, the right side is responsible for just speeds 1 through 4, but the left side is what multiplies those 4 speeds by a coefficient gear ratio of 2.78. As soon as you engage the multiplier by 2.78, those other 4 speeds can instantly become 5, 6, 7, and 8. So here's the switching mechanism itself. It's exactly the same as in the Bugatti, pretty much. You just kind of pull one of these levers, and boom, it switches very instantaneously, very easily. It just goes at a 90-degree angle. And the very interesting thing is that as soon as it's done going through speeds 1 through 4, a second stepper mechanism engages, which basically engages the multiplier. So every 4 switches, it goes a full 360, thus engaging the second stepper mechanism, and boom. Don't worry if you don't quite understand everything just yet, because I am gonna break down the entire mechanism right now. But just for demonstration, I want you to see how I'm changing the speeds. So for this demonstration, I've hooked up an L motor from Power Functions to this whole driving mechanism. And basically right now we're on the 8th speed. So going from the 8th speed to the 1st speed, you're gonna see the engine getting more and more speed. 8th speed, 7th, 6th, 5th, 4th, 3rd, 2nd, and 1st. But you may be wondering, how does this all work? Well, I'm gonna explain everything. As you can see here, I have both a top view and a bottom view. The right side of the bottom view is the same one as the right side of the top view. All right, understood? So first of all, there are two main axles you have to understand where they are. Now this axle right over here is the input for the entire gearbox from the engine. This one over here is basically the output of the entire speed transmission gearbox. Right now we're on the 1st speed. The only 2 selectors that are engaged out of the 4 are the bottom 2. The input axle has engaged into this gear over here, which is just a 1-to-1 ratio, and these gears are transferring power to the right gearbox. When you engage into the driving gear, first of all, it's from a 16-tooth to a 20-tooth gear, which drives the entire gearbox. And then as you can see, once it gets transferred to this side, this engages into the blue gear, making a gear ratio from the black to the blue, which is a 12 to 20. Now, since this axle is the output, it has just one more ratio, which is from a 24 to an 8 tooth gear. When you multiply the 16 to 20, then a 12 to 20, then a 24 to 8, you get a total gear ratio of 1.44. Understood? First, you must multiply this by the ratio inside the gearbox and by the output ratio. All right, you got it? Are we clear? Now let's move on to the 2nd speed. Now for the 2nd speed, as you can see, the 1st part has remained the same since it's basically the multiplier gearbox, but on this side it has changed. The bottom selector is now in neutral and the top one has engaged with the blue gear. For the 2nd speed, the side that multiplies has still remained the same, but the top one instead of the bottom one now has engaged. The motion transfers from here to here and then up here All of these ratios are 1-to-1, except for the last gear here, which is a 16-tooth gear to a 20-tooth gear. When you multiply all of the three ratios, 16-to-20, 16-to-20, and finally 24-to-8, you get a total output ratio of 1.92. For the third speed, there is nothing in the gearbox itself. It's all just 1-to-1 gear ratios, as you can see from the input. It goes here to here, 1-to-1, and then out here into this gear, which again is a 1-to-1 ratio. So you just multiply the initial 16 by 20 to the last 24 by 8 ratio, which you get a final output ratio of 2.4. For the fourth speed inside the whole gearbox, the gear ratio changes and it's now 20 divided by 16. And when you multiply all the three different gear ratios together, you get a total output ratio of 3. Now watch, here's where it gets really, really interesting. When you shift to the fifth speed engages this multiplier, and this multiplier is equal to 20 divided by 12 squared, because it has a 20 tooth gear to a 12 and then another 20 to 12. So that total equates to about 2.78. And when you do transition to the fifth speed, basically the right gearbox, again, since it has completed its cycle of 1 through 4, it's back to its original first speed. But now when you multiply the first speed by the coefficient of 2.78, you get a total output gear ratio of 4. And the rest of the speeds, 6, 7, and 8, are basically 2, 3, and 4, but this time, those gear ratios are multiplied by the coefficient of 2.78. Alright, do you understand that? And it's also important to note that this is a very interesting gearbox, since it is technically a 16-speed transmission gearbox, but because of the way it is designed, 9 through 16 are basically the exact same ratios as 1 through 8. Here, as you can see, for your convenience, I have made a table. Here are all the gears, reverse as well as 1 through 8. The input for all of them is 16 divided by 20, except for the reverse gear, which is 1-to-1. For the actual gearbox transmission of speeds 1 through 4, which is here on the right side from the top view, it's not the multiplier, it's actually, you know, the gearbox, it has the following gear ratios as I have provided here. Also, the multiplier gearbox also has a gear ratio of 1-to-1 for speeds 1 through 4, and then for speeds 5 through 8, it has a coefficient of 2.78. And the output gear ratio for all of them, except for the reverse gear, is 24 divided by 8. And then here on the right column, I also have the final result. How's this gearbox different from the one in the Bugatti? Well, actually, the way all the gears are connected and everything like that is pretty much exactly the same. The only real physical difference is here on the top. It's placed a little bit differently on the gearbox in the Bugatti. Also, one really positive about the gearbox in the Lamborghini Sian FKP 37 42115 is the lack of any clutch gears. I really appreciate this because my gearbox in the Bugatti never, ever, ever worked because it had a clutch gear. It was just always stuck. I always had to drive it in the reverse gear just to be able to see the engine work. I mean, it was terrible, but finally it's fixed here, and I'm super happy that LEGO Technic has, you know, addressed that issue. And I really hope that you found my explanation of the gearbox understandable. I also hope that you learned something from this. If you have any questions regarding your gearbox in the Lamborghini, just leave a comment. I respond to all comments and I'm gonna respond to you, you know? So just ask me any questions if you have those. And this is your unbrick here, and I'll see you in the next one.